Here's something that's new. Check this out. See this? This tree right here. The bottom of the tree is way up there, pointing up in the air. Way up there. That's the bottom of the tree. Top of the tree is right here. Right here. Pushed into the ground. And what's interesting is that a year ago, another one appeared. It's right there. It's still there. Right there. Goes up. Up, 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 up. And what looks like the top of it is right there. See it? That's the bottom of the tree. Pointing upwards. And there's a big tree snap that happened last year too, right there. This is new. Right here. That would take some effort. Holy. I don't know where the tree would have come from. You can see here, there's been some commotion. Look at this. Something's been in here. See? It's been through here. Branches and stuff are all moved around. It's like every once in a while, it's like something makes an attempt to maybe not really block your way, but it makes its presence known by like things like this. It really gets your attention if you're paying attention all the time. That's new. It's within the last, we're going to have to say 10 days that I haven't been out in here for a little bit. Wow. See that? That's the bottom of the tree, right there. You try to lift up a tree and put up against something like that upside down. I bet it takes a lot of effort. I wouldn't be able to do it. All of a sudden, there's a lot of trees leaning up against other trees. I notice one here. This little one way over there. Another one back there. Another one right here. I don't know if this guy's some sort of a territorial marker. I don't know. I know a year and a half or 2 years ago, this was definitely something's territory. Whether or not the individual at least claim to the territory keeps it for a long time or not, I don't know. So I think I hear something. Back in there, somewhere. Like that. I hope the camera picked that up. It came from over there. See anything? Something else. I'm not seeing anything. See, here's some more stuff seemingly put across the trail in front of me. I've been coming through this area now for a long time. I've seen everything happen, from tree snaps like this, the little branches, big branches, trees. Everything seems to get put across the trail. I'll be darned, look at this. See this tree? The importance of this tree. I'm getting cold shivers here just thinking about this. Look at my arms. Well, I can't really see it, but getting goosebumps standing here. It's rather eerie. This tree you're looking at right here is the tree that the creature was standing behind in the video. I have a few versions of it on my channel, but the apple peeker video, when I'm putting up the apples, there's this rather large creature standing behind this tree. This is the tree. He's peeking over top of this upper branch. If I go over there, it's quite a bit over my head. It's about a foot and a half over my head. Well, I had a viewer, his name's Darcey, came up with this kind of interesting idea. He said, "No, I'm going to send you a couple of stuffed animals, and we're going to see, can you see what happens if you put them out somewhere?" So I took the stuffed animals. There was a Bigfoot doll. I stuck him at the top up there, and there was a hockey player man with timber giant Bigfoot on it. And he sent that, and I stuck it in the tree at the bottom. I was waiting for a little while for stuff to arrive. And I talked it over with a fellow on the internet, and he said that, you know, I'm going to send you these two dolls, like a human-shaped doll and a Bigfoot doll. And it'd be interesting to put them out in the trees wherever I do this and see if one of them gets taken or one of them, you know, just what happens. It's like, does this guy get ripped apart and this one just plain old disappears? We'll see. I put my money on this one disappearing myself. Oh, no. Or, you know, it could go the other way and this one could be the one that disappears. I don't know. A Bigfoot wouldn't mind having a Montreal Canadiens number 13. But, you know, I think this one looks very familiar. He just might hit a chord with the creatures looking at this. Or, you know, they may take it completely different and destroy this thing. Who knows?
The critter's right here on this tree. Just because I've had a suspicion before something was going on back here. I just happened to catch that on video. So, I'm going to put Buddy here. There. One there. That's about where that creature's head was. Way up here, and we'll put the unmentionable team with the timber giant Bigfoot on his shirt down here.
That would be fun.
Okay. Nothing's gonna just haphazardly knock that out. They're right in there. Okay, so from this point, we'll see how long it takes for something to happen, if anything at all happens.
And I've been coming out here for a long time now, looking and they're still there, and looking and they're still there. And now I've missed, I don't know, we'll say 8, 9, we'll be generous, we'll say 10 days I haven't come out here. And they're gone. Look at this, eh? They're gone. I don't see them on the ground anywhere. Like, it's not like they couldn't fall out of the tree. They were stuck right in there. Something's come along and got them. See that? I stand up right next to the tree. See? This is me standing in front of this tree. Look how much higher it is than me. And I'm standing up, see? I'm standing here. That thing is monstrously tall in the video. It's not maybe 100% obvious, but it is. It's very big. And it keeps disappearing behind this tree. Well, no, it's possibly the thing that's taken the stuffed animals I left out here. You know, it kind of gives you a weird feeling when there's a bit of a trail here. When you kind of like put the pieces together in your head and you say, you know, something I've done has attracted possibly the creature that I'm trying to just get a glimpse of, or it's a clear photo. Now it's been here, quite possibly. There's another tree that's been blown down, we'll say, I guess. Hey, check this out, right here. You know, a few videos back, I believe I said it, I'm not sure if I used a clip in the video though, I said that sometimes I'll come out here and I'll find, I'm hearing sounds, I'll find sticks that look like walking sticks propped up or hanging from the trees. Well, this is one of them right here. Look at that. It's been sitting here for a few days. It left a little dent in the ground. See? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this. I'm going to walk around with it, use it, and I'll put it back. It's not exactly the best walking stick, but I have had some sticks that I've found hanging in trees low to the ground like that, that I still have. They're like awesome walking sticks. They got like perfect cane tops on them. Anyway. But yeah, it gives you a weird feeling to know that you are possibly interacting with this creature. You know, to just a typical Joe walking around out here, you know, you leave something against or up in a tree and it disappears. Well, you accredit it to maybe a raccoon or, I don't know, maybe the wind blew and the thing fell down and perhaps somebody just happened to walk through here and pick it up. A lot of coincidences there that just have to be right. I don't think I'm in a part of the forest where people typically come. If I didn't know better, it almost looks like there's been more branches added up to this teepee shape there. That big long one's on quite an angle. Right there, and the other one on the far side. I'm not sure if they're new or not. So when you think about it, you know, you start thinking, you know, like I recorded this creature running across here, or walking, I don't know if it was running or walking, moving quite smoothly and swiftly across the top of this ravine from the opposite side. And it kind of gives me the creeps just being out here and thinking about that. It's not too bad as long as I don't think about it. If I start thinking about it, it starts to play games with your mind. Because that thing just came out of nowhere, I swear. Didn't see it, presto, it's there. That seems to be the way it's gone almost every time I have filmed anything. Even when I recorded this video of the big red one that's literally just ahead of me, I think I saw the creature, but I looked at it, and I remember thinking to myself, that looks like the color of an orangutan. And I looked away, and I don't know why. I never even looked back again. I'm hearing a weird sound. Kind of quiet. I'm checking the ground as I'm walking here. I'm looking for a particular bunch of sticks and stuff. It's a shape that I find out in the forest a lot. It's here, I'll draw it. It kind of looks like this. You got a stick. Oops. You got a stick. Another stick. And the last stick, usually four sticks. And over here, there's usually three or four sticks across, shaped kind of like that, made all out of tree branches. And I've been coming across this shape quite a bit out in the forest. The last place I've seen it was quite a ways from here. Yeah, anyways, like I was saying, being in the presence of a giant is a little bit intimidating. That's the word. Intimidating. Here's a branch that's been stuck in the ground. It's not a tree. Look, it's just a stick stuck in the ground. On an angle, too. I know some people think that when they hear me say that it's intimidating to be around these creatures, they think, oh, what a wimp. But when you stop and look at how large these creatures are, you have to realize that every time you or I have seen one, with any kind of distance between us that's not so great, you know, that creature is in control of the situation. If he decided he was going to run over here and, I don't know, beat you senseless or just do whatever they would do, it's completely within his control to do so. There's people out there that are intimidated by my size. And I always find that kind of funny because I'm kind of a bigger person, but I'm one of these friendly people. I don't try to intimidate people. I guess that's kind of what you can say about these creatures. They're large, but they don't seem to openly use their size as an intimidation factor. It's just us that feels intimidated. I think it's an automatic thing. Sometimes when a big person walks into a room full of shorter people, the short people feel that they just don't quite meet the standard, I guess, or the status quo. It's kind of like that when a Bigfoot walks in, too. He's like, holy cow. That guy's big. Okay, I'm going to put the stick back now. There's the spot where it was, right there. Set it right back there again. So if that creature happens to be around, it will have seen me take its stick, walk around with it, and put it back. Mind you, if it was a good walking stick-shaped stick, I would take it home with me. So yeah, Darcey, the animals are gone. I don't see them anywhere. So, needless to say, I should have had one of those plot watcher cameras. Takes a picture every couple of seconds. And I wouldn't have even had to come out here. I would have just came out and got the memory card and developed it or, you know, viewed it. I would have seen what happened. It must have happened at night. I think the creature was probably keeping an eye on it, if it was the creature. And finally, when it knew I hadn't come out here for so long, it felt it was safe to take them. Oh well. I'll bring some other stuff out and put it in the tree. Same tree. See over there? I'll zoom in on it. Right there. I made that. And hung it in the tree way back in the springtime. And it's still hanging there. I can only assume it's a very boring thing and nothing wants to touch it. And it's just barely hanging on the branch, so nothing has even touched it. It would have came off easily. It's really weird is that year and a half ago, I was out here and I would hear this bird. It's kind of how this all started. I would hear a bird. And the bird didn't sound like it belonged out here. It sounded just like what I just heard there. And now that I turn around with the camera, it stops. Okay, so I'm going to turn around again, except this time I'm going to film backwards. Now I'll be out here walking along. See that? As soon as I turn around, I hear that bird again. You hear that? If I turn around, it stops. It's a wood knock. Yeah, I know there's birds around here that sound like that. And some people can even identify the bird. It just seems to be rather ironic that as soon as I turn around, it stops, even though it's hundreds of feet behind me. Figure out this tree though, that's newly placed right here, right there. That's new. So is all this stuff. It's been busted off and just put here across the trail in front of me. So I'm going to tick somebody off. I'm going to take it and put it all to the side. Look, there's a whole bunch of it. It's not just a little bit. It's a bunch of it. And I'm going to put it over there. Right there. You see, there's more of it. Put it all right there. And if something's watching, maybe it will feel the need to put it all back again. There's even a couple more branches down in here, but I'm not going to bother with that. Oh, boy. That is something, though, eh? It's almost done. There's a tree there, upside down. Once in a while, I hear some leaves rustle down here on the ground. Doesn't sound like squirrels. Well, anyway, I am gonna chalk that one up to the creature. Creatures of the forest. That's the area that I've been leaving stuff for these creatures. And everything else except for one thing eventually disappears. No matter how high or how difficult I make it, it disappears. If I tie something with rope, even the rope disappears. So, I don't know. somewhere out here, there's some stuffed animals, a bunch of rope, little pieces of lumber, a whole bunch of stuff. Except for that one gizmo I've got hanging in a tree out there. So, I think the experiment is a success, but on the other hand, it's a failure just because I didn't have the equipment to properly watch the area. Anyway, time to get home.